We live in a world where we use the words love and hate pretty loosely. For example, you may say you love Lucky Charm cereal, but you hate Justin Bieber. You may say you love Marvel movies, but you hate cats. You get the idea. We live in a love-hate culture. Love is a big deal to us. Most of the biggest movies in the theaters have a love story attached to them. A lot of songs that top the charts are about love. Americans alone spend $20.7 billion on Valentine's Day. In the church, we talk about how God loves you and you should love one another. On the other hand, though, we live in a culture that loves to hate on other people or ideas. We bash people on social media, we have opinions on everything, and we form judgments about people we don't even know based simply on their Instagram grids. So if love is such a big deal, why does it seem like hating on people is such a natural part of our lives? There's a lot we could say about the different ways people hate on people, but because we have limited time together today, we're going to focus on just one: gossip. Now, before you roll your eyes and think I'm hating on anybody who hates on somebody else by gossiping, just hear me out for a second, because adults are just as bad as teenagers. But you have to admit that it's a big deal in high school. Am I right or am I right? Think about it. Aren't a lot of the conversations you have about other people? Isn't it true that rumors have ruined some of your classmates' reputations? Don't you sometimes hear stories that seem a bit sketchy on details, but they're full of interesting dirt, so it's fun to talk about? You may be thinking, I don't talk about other people, but I know people who do all the time. But the truth is, we all need to take a look in the mirror and ask ourselves if we contribute to this form of hating. I mean, with all the things we have going on in our lives, why is it so easy to spend time gossiping about other people? Why does gossip have such a strong appeal to us all? I think there's a few big reasons why. Number one, our insecurities. If we can point out what's wrong with other people, it helps us cover up what we feel insecure about within ourselves. Another one is easy bonding. There's no better way to get in with a group of people than by contributing and connecting through gossip. Another could be fun. It's highly entertaining to be the first person to know the juicy details or be in the middle of breaking news about other people. Another could be competitive advantage. Some of us want to be the best, so we'll cut other people down just to show that we are. Or maybe it's truth. Sometimes we justify gossip with the fact that what we're talking about is actually true. We think it's okay because the people we're talking about deserve it or brought it on themselves. Or it could be innocent intentions. Sometimes we just have BFFs that we share everything with. And sometimes everything includes gossip. Like I already mentioned, gossip is an adult thing too. So it's not like you've gotten a lot of great modeling on this topic from people who are older than you. We know parents, teachers, coaches who all tell too much. There are shows, podcasts, YouTube channels dedicated to gossiping about and hating on other people. Social media has ramped this up for sure. You know about subtweeting. And there are famous celebrities who literally are only famous because people gossip about them. They haven't released an album, acted in a movie, or even invented anything world-changing, but they seem to be the trending topic all the time. What a crazy time to be alive. But isn't it true that although gossip is a naturally accepted part of our culture, there's something inside all of us that knows it's not good? I mean, if you've ever been gossiped about, then you know how terrible it feels. It's not fun to be the subject of other people's conversations, especially when they don't have all the details or even know you. I know for me, the only time I want people talking behind my back is if they're complimenting me. Anything else, it just hurts. If gossip is, in fact, a big deal, how should we handle it? Well, let's talk about that together. Interestingly enough, someone who lived a couple thousand years ago might have written some of the best advice on this particular topic. His name is Paul, and he's one of the most famous Christians to ever live. His life was dedicated to starting churches and telling everybody he ran in contact with about Jesus. He would often write letters to the churches he had planted. And eventually, some of those letters will become what we call books of the Bible. One of those letters is now called the Book of Ephesians. It was written to a group of Christians in the ancient city of Ephesus, which was a bustling port city full of culture, diversity, and religions. It was a town full of a bunch of people with a bunch of differences. This type of setting is the perfect fuel for gossip. There was plenty to talk about, plenty to disagree on, and plenty to judge. In fact, for the people Paul wrote to, Jesus followers, it would have been easy for them to judge what they saw in the people of that town. And it would have been super easy for them to gossip. But Paul wanted the Christians in Ephesus to operate differently than culture. So his letter is all about them, as followers of Jesus, living unique lives. Here's what he had to say. Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths. In this one sentence, Paul makes it clear that unwholesome talk is not supposed to be a part of our lives. This letter was originally written in Greek. And if we were to look at the original word for unwholesome in the Greek, one of its meanings is rotten. And that, y'all, is a great word to describe what gossip is. Gossip rots our friendships, relationships, and reputations. This isn't what we want to produce with our lives, is it? We don't want to be people who put out a rotten vibe. When we participate in or initiate gossip, we're actually contributing to the rotting of some of the things that matter most to us and the people around us. In fact, not only does it rot things around you, it might actually be an indication of something unwholesome on the inside of you. Jesus himself talked about this. It's not what goes into your body that defiles you. You are defiled by what comes from your heart. According to Jesus, what comes out of you says a lot about what's within you. When you gossip, it shows something about you. More than the words you speak, it's about the motivation that causes you to say certain things or participate in certain conversations. It's an issue of the heart. But back to Paul. He gives us an alternative to the unwholesome gossip. Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. In other words, if you choose to put the needs of others ahead of your own, and when you think about who a person is, instead of just judging them, you'll stop yourself from gossiping. You'll think about them before you speak about them. If you choose to build others up, care about their needs, and help them, you'll choose words that benefit them instead of words that bash them. I get that this is a lot easier said than done. Trust me, I do. In a world where gossip is really trendy, it's hard to be the guy or girl who chooses wholesome over unwholesome. I mean, that just sounds boring, doesn't it? But I think it will help you to think about it through the filter of this question. What do you want to be all about? Do you want to be known as someone who loves others or as someone who is simply a hater? The good news is that you have a choice. You get to decide who you want to be and what you will be known for. The bad news is that you could become known for being someone who is viewed as a hater if you choose to take part in the gossip that is all around you. But I want you to know that God wants you to be all about something else. That's why he gives you the power to be different. Just because gossip is fun, normal, or even trendy, it doesn't mean you have to participate. Instead, you and I could choose to be about something else. We could seek the kind of reputation Paul talked about, one where we're known as people who use words to help others, build others up, and make their needs a priority. We simply choose love over hate. Think of it this way. Let love be what you're all about. Of all the things we could be known for, let's start with the thing that Jesus said was the greatest, love. This starts in our hearts, with us making a decision to value and care about other people. It then transfers to our words. We all have a way of deciding what we say. Here are a few of the filters we commonly use. Will it make me look funny? Will it make me look cool? Will it make me look smart? Is it mostly true? These filters often lead to unwholesome talk. And before we know it, something rotten comes out of our mouths. We need a new filter, and I really like the one Paul gives us because it ties in perfectly if we want to be people who are all about love. It's a very straightforward filter, and it goes like this. Is this helpful? Before you and I say anything, we should use this filter. In fact, we can put it into practice immediately. We can start today in small group. We can start today when we get home. All we need to ask is, will these words be helpful? Will they build others up? Will they show the world that I'm all about loving others? If we choose to be all about love and use this filter, the words we should and shouldn't use will become really clear. It's actually pretty amazing how practical a filter that's thousands of years old is in today's world. Imagine for a moment if just those of us in this room chose to let love be what we're all about, and we chose not to build our lives around gossip and negative talk. Imagine if we chose to be people who use words to help and build up others. This would have an impact on the world around us. In fact, it may just change the view some people have of Christians. Imagine if Christians were known for being all about love instead of hate. How much more appealing would it be to follow God? How much more magnetic would the church be? All of us get to decide whether we'll be known for being about love or being a hater. Let's let love be what we're all about.